Thank you. My name is Ishla Rakova, and I manage Tulele Pesa in Bougainville, Papua New Guinea. I'm here as one of the speakers, basically to share the experiences of the work I'm doing in relocating or moving cartridge islanders impacted by climate change and rising sea levels from the island to mainland Bougainville.
Okay, how long has it been going?
Yeah, the cartridge islands have been facing sea level rise, shoreline erosion, frequent storm surges, unpredictable weather changes, loss of food, and a huge amount of the land has been washed away. We are looking at 40 to 60 meters of land washed away. We have lost food gardens. We can no longer grow a lot of the food crops we would have grown 50, 60 years ago. It's heavily impacting on food. There is scarcity of arable land to plant food. The nutrition of the islanders is changing dramatically. There is malnutrition, and we've had people who have actually died of hunger. It's been happening for the last 30, 40 years. I remember that in 1984, we lost one of the islands. It was divided in half due to a strong current and just washing away of the shorelines. And that was also when we started to realize the sea was intruding further inland and washing away our food gardens. We would witness the yellowish of the yellowish color of the food plants turning and eroding fast. And when it's high tide, we can also see the water seeping out of the land, through the land and onto, basically just there, making it very difficult to subside and dry away, resulting in a lot of vector-borne diseases. I'm saying this is cause of impacts of climate change because we did not realize, we never really witnessed that when I was a small girl. And now we witness periods where we just have mosquitoes like swarming at you as if, you know, they were flies.
Which diseases?
Malaria, malaria attacks, dysentery, and now we have a lot more of our people suffering from high blood pressure as well.
And what's that from?
I think it's just anxiety because they don't know where what's going to happen. We have an increase in storm surges, but also we actually have witnessed a rise in the level of the sea because we are 1.2 meter above sea level, and when it's high tide and you are sleeping on the sand, it's like the sea is higher than the land. So it's very, very, it's a scary feeling.
Yeah. Moved yet?
We have moved, we have successfully moved 10 families. We are looking at 103 heads. So the number of the population in our new site increases and decreases because we have extended families coming over when life is really too difficult on the island. They move and they come and stay with us for a few months and then they return home.
Where?
We we have been gifted four sites on mainland Bougainville, but the first site is on the northeast coast of Bougainville Island in Papua New Guinea. There's been some issues where we had to create ceremonies with our host community. We've had situations where we had to take part in cultural activities because we are now there, and now we actually given an observer status in the local level government. But we continue to do a lot of cultural exchanges, and we continue to do that because we want to solidify our relationships and assimilation into the community.
Okay, so is that community?
The future is that we are part of this community, but we maintain our cultural significance, especially language, by just continuing to speak it. We now have a trend where our younger generation, who were very small children when they moved, who can speak bilingual, so they speak the island language as well as the host language.
And so what do you want to see happen?
I would like to see in the future that our language is maintained, but then our community is bilingual, so that we understand their culture, we understand and we can fit into their culture. And we can also speak their language. That's one of the things I'd like to see happen, and I'm already seeing that. But I would also like to see our elder coming onto our new site and teaching our young people the customs of our island. I strongly denounce this kind of development, because the change in weather pattern is being caused by what the industrialization did so many thousands of years ago, and we are now coming face to face with the impacts that were caused, and having to look into new destructive development like this is just beyond the human capacity. It is destroying the fabrics of people's lives to have a decent life.
So what would you say to the government here?
Australia is a big country in the Pacific. Australia needs to rethink the way it is looking at development. It is our biggest neighbor. It is our biggest brother. Why isn't it looking into the rights of ordinary communities who cannot help themselves, who are the most vulnerable communities, unable to help themselves? And Australia should really be looking at that. It should be looking at people's rights to live a decent life.
So what would you like to see?
Australia should be using the funds that it has got from fossil fuel mining, from coal mining, and invest into communities, communities or nations, island nations, that are going through climate change impacts and rising sea levels, so that they are finding their own way out of their misery. The most vulnerable communities are actually Pacific island nations that are not able to finance themselves, that are not able to finance their movement into safe and secure lands. I would really like to see Australia play a big part in financing island communities in the Pacific, and even finding a better way to solving climate migration. Not just finding a way, but financing climate migration in the Pacific. It is about Australia taking a bigger responsibility in its actions. Australia can continue to discuss climate policies and statistics about impacts of, you know, climate change in the Pacific or even in Australia. How about the small island states in the Pacific that are going through climate displacement? They are not talking about it. They are actually doing it. So we cannot continue to talk anymore. It is time that we put our hands into our mouths and, you know, basically say, this is how much I'm going to do, and this is what I'm going to do, and this is the way out of the misery that you are facing right now.